details in the new Afghan great game is training the Afghan army. A high-stakes game is what we're debating, among other things. Joining us live from Islamabad, Lieutenant General Talat Masood, his former defense secretary in Pakistan, Vivek Kaju, former ambassador to Afghanistan from India, and probably knows the area, including Pakistan and Iran, the back of his palm. And we'll also get Brigadier Gurmeet Kamal, who's the director of Center for Land Warfare Studies, joining us. General Talat Masood, just coming to you, sir, first. We heard Nitin say there that India will tread carefully, but even going to the stage that we are now, that is ratcheting up a certain extent, at least, training of the army and Afghan national security forces. What's the view in Islamabad?
Well, I don't think Pakistan is looking at it. It's rather concerned, because I think it gives rise to a lot of feelings here that India, the Afghan army is more or less leaning towards India. Most of the officers and also the other ranks are getting training in India. Weapons and equipment are also flowing into Afghanistan. And with the type of relationship that we have had and continue to have, this sort of development is, of course, bothersome and is creating, great concern in Pakistan. But obviously, with certain positive developments that have taken place between India and Pakistan in the recent past, I think India should look at it more in a cooperative sense rather than trying to develop Afghanistan as one of its proxies, because this is the concept that is developing, especially because
General Masood,
the relationship.
It's strange that you say that, because that's exactly the feeling here, that India and Pakistan should be cooperating on Afghanistan. There shouldn't be a confrontation, and the view on this side of the fence is that Pakistan doesn't do that. It's even supporting agencies. Its agencies are supporting terror groups that will be hitting Indian assets in Afghanistan.
Well, actually, I look at it like this, that, the Pakistan army, and in Pakistan there is a feeling that the Afghan army is essentially not really a national army in that true sense. It's underrepresented, and it has a leaning towards India, and they are somewhat hostile towards Pakistan. And then with so much of training going on in India, obviously the future of the Afghan army will be more more leaning towards, again, India.
Right.
And that is what is the experience of countries which have sent their officers for training to other countries. They develop a bond which necessarily may, in our context, may not be helpful unless the relationship moves to a point of that level of confidence is achieved between the two countries.
The level of confidence. Ambassador Kaju, does Pakistan have anything to worry about by us training the army? The points that's being raised there, and they are accusing us of being non-cooperative in Afghanistan.
No, I see no reason for any concern in Islamabad or Rawalpindi because of the strategic agreement that has been reached between India and Afghanistan. There has been a long tradition of training of Afghan armed forces, but if one takes the specific context of the present Afghan National Army, it has been trained mainly by the West. Mm-hmm. We've had no role in it, except for a little bit of training. I'm happy that now that training process will be upgraded. After all, we have a direct relationship with Afghanistan. That relationship is not directed against any third country. Mm-hmm. And if a third country has illusions, well, we cannot help it.
Illusions, would you say, General Masood, how would you respond to that? That training the Afghan army is probably just a drop in the ocean in comparison to what the West has done, that is India training the army.
Well, that is true, but I believe that the government of Afghanistan and the Afghan army leadership is thinking more in terms of sending their officers to India. And by and large, this development, obviously, unless the relationship between India and Pakistan totally normalizes, would be looked at with suspicion. So I think you have to understand the sensitivities that exist. I mean, in the sense that as it is, we don't feel that the present Afghan army is somewhat better disposed towards Pakistan, and if it is also trained in that way, mm-hmm. and our relations do not continue to improve, yep, then the concerns will increase.
I just come to you, Ambassador. I'm just going to join on the phone line by Brigadier Gurmeet Kamal, Director of Center for Land Warfare Studies. Brigadier Kamal, thanks for joining us. I believe some technical problems, so that's why we're joining you on the phone line there. Ratcheting up in a sense from where India was in terms of training the Afghan army, what are your thoughts on that?
The Afghan army at present is ill-trained, poorly equipped, and badly led. Particularly, the standards of junior leadership need to be upgraded by an order of magnitude. And if they were to be trained by India, the results would be much better than the results that have been achieved by training through NATO and ISAF groups. And the ideal, in my view, would be to get there on the ground and train them in large numbers, a battalion at a time, so that the training is cohesive and carried out systematically. That would involve putting some troops on the ground for local protection. So it's a million-dollar question whether the Indian government would be willing to take that risk or not.
Right, Brigadier Kamal. In fact, so far, what we know is that India is avoiding sending training teams to Afghanistan because of the vulnerability of attacks, but there's going to be a rapid expansion in terms of platoon-level and company-level training, maybe at specialized institutions like the Commander School in Belgaon, the Counterinsurgency Jungle Warfare School in Mizoram, as well as High Altitude Warfare School in Sonamarg. But we just had General Talat Masood. He is still with us from Islamabad, voicing Pakistan's concerns on this. What are your thoughts on that, Brigadier Kamal?
Pakistan's concerns are genuine. In case Indian troops are there in Afghanistan, the concerns are genuine. That is why my suggestion is that Indian troops for training should be sent to the north, to Mazar-e-Sharif, or to the west, to Herat, well away from Pakistan's border. That will address Pakistan's concerns to a very large extent.
Again, your thoughts quickly before I let you go. Negotiations are still stuck on an Afghan wish list, which includes a supply of tanks, artillery guns and ammunition. Do you think we should go that far?
We should give them everything that they ask for. We failed to do that in Sri Lanka, and we drove the Sri Lankans into the arms of the Chinese. Similarly, we failed to do that for Myanmar, and we drove Myanmar into the arms of the Chinese. Now we are trying to woo them back. We should give the Afghans every single item of military hardware that they ask for.
Right, Brigadier Kamal, thanks for joining us. Would have liked to have contacted you visually, but there was a technical problem there. The Director of Center for Land and Warfare Studies, Admiral Ambassador Karzai, you wanted to make a point, I think, earlier.
Yes, I think the point being made in Islamabad is that we should show sensitivities to their concerns because of improvement in our ties with Pakistan. Now, this is strange. Pakistan, for tactical reasons, has taken certain steps. There's no evidence of a change in strategy or a change in strategic thinking.
Okay. I just have to interrupt you because I'm going to lose the Islamabad link, so I just want to quickly go to General Talat Masood. You're talking about training of the army, but on another hand, we've seen some movement, whether it's step by step, in terms of India and Pakistan trade relations, MFN status, other things that are moving along pretty well. Do you think that this will be an impediment to that, the larger question of Indo-Pak talks? General Masood, you have, I think, about 30 seconds before we lose you.
Well, I think, there are still some very strong resistance both in India and Pakistan against this forward movement, which I think majority of the people, though, welcome it in Pakistan as well as I hope in India too. But with this sort of developments, then these forces become more vocal and it becomes very difficult for the government to then proceed on the peace process. So I think we have to take this into consideration. To what extent India wants to get involved in Afghanistan, especially with this sort of a relationship which is rather fragile at the moment, but moving in the right direction.
Right, moving in the right direction, Lieutenant General Talat Masood. I do believe we'll lose that line there with you in Islamabad soon. Thanks so much for joining us here. It was a pleasure as usual. I just want to, before I come to you, Ambassador, get in some views or questions from the audience. I think some people had some questions here. Yeah.
Recently, Mr. Karzai made a statement that if Pakistan ever went to a war, we would support Pakistan no matter who the opposition is. In that context, how much this strategic partnership would benefit India?
I just want to clarify that has been a very controversial statement, but it was probably taken out of context. It was an interview to Geo Television in Pakistan. Yeah. And if you look at the whole transcript, there was only this part was picked up by the media again. The whole transcript of his interview, he talks about 95% is about Pakistan, how Pakistan has to stop terror, how Pakistan is a brother but should not be stabbing its own brother. So that has probably been taken out of context, but you're free to add to that, Ambassador.
No, I generally agree with you. In any relationship with another country, we've got to take our interests into account. Mm-hmm. And naturally, while we have a strategic partnership with many countries, including Afghanistan, we've got to be careful. And we always have to consider the totality of the situation. So the point you've made is valid. We will have to monitor President Karzai. He has a track record and we should monitor it.
I don't think you would say anything more. Some other questions?
With 2014 approaching very soon, it's high time that the regional players in South Asia start taking start playing a better role in Afghanistan.
Sure.
So given that fact, I think India is at a very is at the best position to take a better role in Afghanistan's development, given the other options like China and Pakistan.
Development.
Yeah.
What about military training? We already $2 billion.
Development as well as military training.
Okay.
Let's focus on the military training.
Okay.
Given the fact that in India we have seen that the military has never crossed this line. It has never come into the political domain or has played any other role, as we have seen the case in Pakistan.
Sure.
So the military in India is at a far better place to give a proper disciplined training to Afghanistan's army as compared to any other country in South Asia.
Again, now if you put it into context, the Bonn conference, the Istanbul conference, where we were invited this time, unlike last time in January. So there is a multi-pronged effort that India has in the region and especially in Afghanistan, and that seems to be being recognized worldwide.
Yes, I think that's a very good development for our diplomacy, and our diplomats need to be congratulated for that achievement. Mm-hmm. The world has recognized that we have a role, and our role should be to respond to Afghanistan's needs. Our traditional emphasis has always been to respond to whatever the Afghans want to the extent that we can. We've always told them that, look, we are afraid, we don't have any prescriptions. To the extent that we can help you, we'll be very happy to help you as a friend. Mm-hmm. And that should be the guiding principle also, to my mind, when it comes to military training or supply of military equipment. Mm-hmm. And naturally, one has to take a totality of the situation into account. But at all times, and I emphasize this, we've got to take our interests into account, not the sensitivities of a neighbor like Pakistan. Of course, the way our relations with Pakistan are moving at the moment is a welcome development. And we've got to take that into account. But as for me, I have not seen any real evidence that there has been a change in the Pakistani mindset, that they now truly wish to put the past behind us and to say that, yes, we now want to develop good neighborly relations, friendly relations with India.
Right.
They've not changed the strategic doctrine at all.
So they have not changed the strategic doctrine. I'm afraid I'm out of time, though. I would like to ask you about the Haji Kak mines that we would probably get and how we ensure security there, maybe for another day. Ambassador Kaju, General Talat Masood, and Brigadier Gurmeet Kamal, thanks for joining us on this discussion.